from the laws of Sefira. And anyway, we're just talking about counting of Sefira itself. There's much Kabbalah associated with Sefira, but we're going to basically, you know, some of the laws that we have associated with Sefira. So we're going to run through a couple of ideas, just so we have the clarity. So we mentioned the idea there's a mitzvah to count the days and the nights. Basically, the way it's done is you say the bracha, you count the days, days and weeks. Count the days followed by the weeks. If a person forgot to count, it's all based on the concept of berachos hamitzvos. Whenever you have a mitzvah to make a bracha, there are different types of mitzvos. There's what we call berachos hashevach, blessings of praise. Berachos hamitzvah, when you make a blessing on a mitzvah. Berachos hanehenin, blessings on something you benefit from. Those are the three main categories of what we have what's known as a mitzvah. So a bracha, berachos hananin, is you have a fruit. You make a bracha on the fruit. You have to make a bracha on the fruit. Can I eat the fruit without a bracha? No, I cannot. Berachos hamitzvah. If I don't make a bracha, do I fulfill my mitzvah? Yes. But there's a special bracha associated with it. So in a scenario, a person is not sure if you made a bracha on something and you have a mitzvah associated with it, or we're not sure if the place you're doing the mitzvah is appropriate, we'll tell a person not to make a bracha. What's the case in point? If a person has to light Shabbos candles. So you have to light Shabbos candles. So oftentimes you go to a hotel, they don't let you light in the hotel room, they tell you want you to light outside. Okay, if you're lighting outside and you're not really benefiting from the light that you're lighting, because it's not in the dining room where you're eating and it's not in the place where you're sleeping, now they'll say, we cordoned off a place for you to light over here, so you might light, but you're not going to make a bracha on that lighting. Because it's questionable if you're actually fulfilling your mitzvah of lighting in that scenario. So that's a scenario where you're going to actually fulfill a mitzvah and not make a bracha. Similarly, by the way, just parenthetically, with regards to candlelighting, in those types of scenarios, according to most, you'd be able to flick on a light switch before Shabbos, and that would be your candlelighting, and that would suffice. So that's how a person would do it. But you have a scenario where you're doing a mitzvah, but because of the fact we're unsure of certain things, we're not going to have you make a bracha. So too in the case of Sefirat HaOmer. In certain scenarios, we're going to tell a person, we're not going to have you make a bracha anymore because of the fact that perhaps you didn't do it appropriately. What is that scenario? If a person missed a day. So let's say it's day 15 of Sefirat HaOmer, and you forgot, and they get to show you go today, you know, they count 15, you go 15, thought it's 14. I've been counting wrong the whole time. So you missed a day. You know that you missed a day. So since Sefirah is looked at as potentially each day is its own separate mitzvah, or it's looked at one mitzvah that's 49 days, therefore, if you missed it, we tell you, okay, you can count without a bracha anymore. But someone says, but it's not fair. I'm just going to stop counting. No, you're missing the point. You know, it's like lighting candles without a bracha. You can still count, just don't say a bracha. You still fulfill your obligation. But because there is a view that says that it's one long mitzvah, and because of that view, we're concerned that if you miss the day, you miss the generality of Sefira, the whole thing. Therefore, we tell you not to count with a bracha. But according to other view, you're certainly fulfilling the mitzvah, even though you're not making the bracha itself. So that's how a person would actually be able to do it. So there's always questions every year about someone who forgets, and then what happens if the rabbi forgets? How does he count? And people would get embarrassed if they forgot, that they missed a day. So I remember I had a neighbor who used to always pretend as if he was counting, because he would usually miss like the third night of Sefira. It's anywhere between the first and the fifth night he would miss Sefira, like classically almost every year. So when he would count, you know, so the chazan counts, and then it's time for everybody else to count, but you don't want to feel like you're not counting. So he'd say, Baruch Atah, and then he'd just go silent on that, and he wouldn't finish the bracha, and then he would just count with everybody else. But I don't think anybody here has that issue of embarrassment, but this is how a person would generally do it. So because of the fact we have this one long mitzvah, it's called the mitzvah feisha zman grama, it's a time-bound mitzvah. Time-bound mitzvah means that it's not all the time that it happens, and therefore men are obligated, and women are generally not obligated in time-bound mitzvahs. So what happens when a woman is not obligated in a time-bound mitzvah? A mitzvah that's based on time. So for Ashkenazim, if they want, they can fulfill the mitzvah. For Sfardim, they cannot fulfill the mitzvah with a blessing. And that's why for Sfardim, if a woman wants to pick up a lulav and shake it, she cannot make the bracha on that lulav. So too would be with Sefirat HaOmer, since it's a time-bound mitzvah, they wouldn't actually count with a bracha. But for Ashkenazim, they can. The question, what if a woman knows for sure she's going to forget? So it would assume that we still have her count in the beginning. Similarly, with children as well, if a child wants to count, we can allow them to count. It is noteworthy to mention the concept when a child is 12 years old turning bar mitzvah, and he has his bar mitzvah in the middle of Sefira. It's a whole long discussion with that in itself. But if a person is turning bar mitzvah in the middle of Sefira, so at the start of Sefira, he's a child. He's not obligated in mitzvos. And then in the middle of the year, he becomes obligated in mitzvos. What does he do? Does he count? Does he continue counting? or does he not continue counting with a bracha? It's a fantastic question. It's a long discourse on this question. Part of the question would be, you say, well, you didn't miss a day. Yeah, but you're somebody else. Similarly, the question goes on a ger, someone who converts prior to Sefirah and then converts in Sefirah. Once he got into Sefirah, this is the first time he's obligated mitzvahs, but he missed the beginning. But maybe you can say, katan, a child, didn't miss the beginning. He started. He was just a child, just not yet fully obligated. Unlike a convert, that's for another time. We'll get to that discussion. If a person is going to be an onin is a person who lost a loved one and therefore cannot fulfill any mitzvahs. If he cannot fulfill any mitzvahs until burial happens, so what does he do when he has Sefirat HaOmer? Sometimes it may take 2 days for burial to actually take place. So what do you do? You're not allowed to fulfill any mitzvahs. The only mitzvah we tell an Oni to do is he has to wash his hands for Netilas Yadayim before eating bread, and in the morning for Modani. Otherwise, he's not allowed to say blessings. He's not allowed to say any prayers. He can't even go to a minyan. He doesn't even count in a minyan. So what do you do in a scenario when you have an Oni, someone who lost a loved one, has a burial coming up in 2 days from now? How is he going? He's going to miss Sefirah. What do you do? So the answer is you have him count without saying a blessing. Why is he counting then? How is he fulfilling his mitzvah over here? So in that scenario, we tell him, you're counting not to fulfill the mitzvah, you're counting actually so you can actually connect the counts together. Count the number that you're connecting, you're linking the chain of whatever days were before to the days you're up to. It's as if you're not actually fulfilling the mitzvah, you don't want to lose out on the counting, but you're not actually fulfilling the mitzvah. So that's how it's actually done in that scenario. He would say it without a blessing, and the rest of the days, he's as if he didn't miss, because he still connected the days, he did not miss the count, and therefore he's still considered what we call in the game, and he would be able to count succeeding days with the bracha. But that's a scenario that happens, obviously, often, because of the fact that a person may perhaps miss a day. Similarly, you have issues, which is a bigger question. That bigger question is the scenario when person is traveling the dateline. Person is traveling the dateline and he misses Sefirah. It's another day. It went from Monday to Wednesday. Where did Tuesday go? What do I do? That's a big discussion. And what do you do when you're on your way back? And then you come back, you're like, I already did this already. You know, what am I supposed to count over here? Do I count? Do I not count? Great question, not for now. Okay, when is the time for Sefirat HaOmer? So it's Kol HaLaila, it's the entire night, because the whole concept of having a Tumim day, a full day, that full day must include the entirety of the day. So if it includes the entirety of the day, it means that as long as I began at night, that means my entire day is included. But if I didn't begin at night and I started a little bit in the day, I lost out perhaps on part of my day. It's therefore why the mitzvah we say is that you have entire night to be able to do it. In order to be able to fulfill this mitzvah. If again, as we mentioned, but we'll go say it again, if a person forgot to count Sefirah the entire night, and then he remembered in the next day, so he remembered in the morning, he might be missing out on a particular aspect of the count. It's for this reason he's going to count without a blessing. He'll count without a blessing. So if a person missed day 15, but now he remembered in the midday or whatever in the daytime that he didn't count, so he's going to count and he's just going to say, today is the 15th day of the Omer, which is 2 weeks and 1 day. Like that math, pretty good, yeah? So he's going to be able to count in that scenario. And the next night, he's going to be able to count with a blessing. Because of the fact that he still had Ritzuf, he still was able to combine all the days and not miss a counting. And so that reason, we consider it as if he has an entirety over there. That's where we're going to stop for this evening.